The Rob game one, what do you think of this character choice from me?
So, let's be very honest. Rob is a really good answer to Hero. However, I'm not entirely sure how I feel about this, specifically because this is also a really good stage for Rob. If Rob is playing on this stage, you have to be really careful because you don't have a lot of chances to kill, especially if you're playing somebody like really neutral heavy. So when you are playing somebody like that, this is probably the one big thing that we're looking for is like, how is Silvio going to be able to take these stocks? Is Silvio going to be able to take these stocks in a timely fashion? And what we're already seeing is a really good, like a nice 87% being able to put on the board. And I'm really kind of curious to see how Silvio is going to be able to take these stocks.
Yeah, I mean, in that early bounce did so much work, not allowing Fawn to slow down the pace of the game, lean on Gyro, lean on Laser, like Rob's like to do, right? Slow down, control the pace at low percent, and allowed Silvio to find some openings, get a early 100%, but just like that, right, Fawn is starting to bring it back. I don't know, I think that was an intentional B-reverse on the Laser there, just an opting not to try and contest Silvio. Oh, and gonna have a juggle situation, but a fantastic air dodge delay for Silvio to reverse the situation. Fawn now just trying to get back and hold on to the stock with a psych up on deck.
Absolutely, and that was really nice on Silvio's end. Ooh, and the really nice reverse side B to be able to pull that kill. That was so nice on Silvio's end, taking that first stock. And we definitely need to see really something to be able to have this as an even game on Fawn's end. But getting that accelerado, making it very much easier for Silvio to be able to come back to stage. And now this is where we have a really hard time for Fawn playing neutral.
And Jazzy, it's not just the ability for him to get back to stage. It's also, right, the combos that come out of Accelerado, but who needs combos when you just deal a whole lot of damage? Oomph online now for Silvio here, and Fawn just trying to find any way to keep this advantage state going. The gyro's gonna keep the reset once, not twice, but the zoom gonna allow him to get out of dodge, and Fawn not able to catch it just there, but finding the down throw to close it out.
Absolutely, and that was very nice on Fawn's end. Just waiting, being able to get that really nice grab. And that was the one thing that she needed to be able to get that stock. But we're still at 105%, and this is really scary because Silvio is just keeping up this lead, and he definitely has a definite really big handle on this matchup right now.
Yeah, no, he's doing a fantastic job, right? Slowing down the pace of the game and kind of scaring Fawn away from using as many of these zoning tools and just fading back, catching the approach, but now he has to find his way out of the corner, and this is where Rob can thrive, right? Throwing on these pressure with these grounded down tilts, finding not one but two trips, gonna find a little bit of a vertical extension here. Now the laser, Silvio off stage, gonna get caught by the gyro, and the re-grab is gonna give Fawn a great opportunity to close the stock out.
Honestly, I love this. This is really good on Silvio's end, and Silvio, like, has definitely been finding. Whoa there, buddy. Did you see that?
I mean, yeah, sometimes you just get Kamehameha, you know?
No, like, that wasn't even Kamehameha. Like, honestly, no, that was, like, not even close. That was literally, like, that was red. Kamehameha is, like, blue.
I mean, it's a big fireball.
Then that's not even a fireball. That's key.
Super Hadouken? Are you happy? Is that better?
I want to say this is a lot better, honestly. Okay. Like, this is literally, like, a Street Fighter character in disguise. Like, I don't know what you're talking about. Look, these literally neutral beast, what is it called again? I don't know. It's called something. And it's really good on Silvio's end. And this is, like, again, kind of the thing that we talk about when it comes to hero players. Silvio is definitely a really good, like, character mastery of this character.
This is so, yeah. Like, again, like, calling out the landing. And we're going to see Fawn immediately switch over to the Duck Hunt. Tried and true. Ooh, Fawn in contention for the best Duck Hunt player in the world, along with Embo. And, you know, I mean, like, the last couple weeks, she's been taking the stocks of some of the top players in the world all over, getting wins on Jackal, Quinn,
ZD
with his
God.
Character, and starting it off with a 30% to death on Silvio, just the double dunk there to seal it out.
Absolutely, that was such a good edge guard coming on from Fawn, and now she's definitely going to be keeping this lead because she ain't want to lose nothing. This is my game.
Yep. Yo, what do you do when a character is going to try and camp you? You're going to get spiked. But I mean, I was going to say, you know, you try and get more off not interacting than they do, but it's not going to matter if Silvio just coming back into it, Lux on inside, not only did he find the setup, but finds a crit, and all Fawn can do now is try and catch these landings, try and keep him in the corner, but not able to do so, and Silvio's ability to find these accelerados over and over and over has just been the difference maker so far early.
Absolutely, and I really love this game right now. Being that this is Fawn's main, it's definitely looking like a much closer game right now that we're seeing this Duck Hunt right, and I definitely love both the way that these two players are playing this right now. I really love the way that, you know, Silvio is using a lot of these tools to his advantage and just taking on a lot of, like, you know, pressure. But we also see on Fawn's end being able to edge guard Silvio to a really good extent. But we are going to see that side B, and it's going to be able to take off that stock at 140-something%. I think
yep.
so. That
now,
looks about right.
And
yeah?
now that Psycup not going to do too much, right? Just going to catch it forward till at zero, only doing about 17. Still a lot, but not what Silvio ideally would have wanted there. However, finds a kaboom to allow him to take center stage, and now Duck Hunt backed into the corner. Doesn't have the room that Fawn is used to working with, but going to find the up air juggle. A second one is going to close it out. That move's kill power is, you know, the key, right? The glue, the bind Duck Hunts get together.
Absolutely, and I really love the way that, you know, Silvio is going about moving. We've had such a really big, like, movement situation right there on Silvio's end, and I feel like Silvio really does know how to be able to maneuver around a lot of Duck Hunt's tools, and I definitely really love this, but it's not looking too well right now for Silvio because Silvio's at 106%.
Yeah.
Silvio is at a point right now where he has to be able to kind of clutch this out with those really good neutral Bs that we see on his end. And oh my god, you saw the way he flew!
Yeah, but the bounce, right, the fact that that can came in and hit Fawn actually probably saved her there. Silvio, even with the accelerator auto, wasn't able to get back. The backer's not going to do it from center stage, Jazzy, and this could be the second chance that Fawn needs, but not if you get caught again. But this time, Silvio's going to miss that sweet spot. Fawn's going to get a third lease on life, and you know what they say, third time's the charm, can she close it out?
Oh my god, and that dash attack was so good. Gonna try and hit that into Silvio, but no, it's not going to work. And now Fawn is in a really bad position. Oh. She's gonna die at 180%. That was so good
yeah.
on Silvio's end. So I really love this.
That was untackable, probably because of compound knockback. Not only was it from the tornado up B, but also she got hit by the can, right, which compounds your knockback. You get... Right, she gets hit by both, and then the speed of it increases, which makes it untackable, and then sends her off into the blast zone. So, unfortunate situation, right, getting caught by both. But that's the downside of having those frame one options like can, is that sometimes, well, they blow up in your face.
Mm-hmm. And not only that, it's actually really hard to actually tech when you're using up, or when you're getting hit by up B. So the issue is that up B has a lot of hits, and there's a lot more behind it than I'm explaining right now, but it's actually one of the hardest moves to tech because there's from what I know, it's a multi-hit, obviously.
Yes.
So that just makes it a little bit harder in order to tech it, but
it's more awkward because sometimes you fall out, sometimes you
I just know from what Silvio's told me that it's really hard to tech, but this is something that I've actually been seeing.
I also want to say as well that one of the things you can do to help out with that is you can LSI down, which means when you're in knockback, you can hold left stick down, and if you hold it up, your knockback's actually going to go slightly faster. If you hold down, it's going to go slightly slower, and you can actually use it to adjust tech windows. So you can, at low percents, you can use it to get a tech when you otherwise just wouldn't get put in a tech situation.
Yeah.
And at high percents, you can hold down to slow your knockback down a little bit to increase the window in which you can
look
tech
at that
before
cheesy
it becomes untechable.
We need a replay on that one. You saw that cheesy smile.
Oh, yeah.
No, I love that, but I also hate that. No, what's going on here?